Hi, in this episode of Redneck 101, we're talking about the love that our Lord Jesus Christ has for soldiers and for police.
There is a Redeemer, Jesus, God's own Son, precious Lamb of God, Messiah, Holy One.
A popular thought these days among left-wing radicals is that the professions of arms are inherently evil, that somehow those who bear the sword on behalf of government are in need of repentance for the very work that they're called to. The purpose of this video is to examine this idea in light of New Testament revelation. Are soldiers and police the moral equivalent of prostitutes, drug dealers, and traffickers who are unable to find redemption and repentance without leaving their profession? John the Baptist instructed those who came to him for baptism to produce fruit in keeping with repentance. The soldiers who came to John the Baptist asked, "What shall we do?" John didn't tell them to repent of being soldiers. He told them, "Don't extort money, don't accuse people falsely, and be content with your pay." First century Roman soldiers had both a military and law enforcement function. Thus, in the prophet John's words, we find God's explicit approval of these for their government tasks, provided that soldiers and policemen carry out their tasks honestly. Repentance is called for based on how their job is done. If soldiers or police extort money, accuse people falsely, or are discontent with their pay. Matthew chapter 8 records a Roman centurion coming to Jesus to ask for healing for his servant who was paralyzed and suffering terribly. The centurion realized that Jesus had authority over the created realm, just as a centurion has authority over the 100 Roman soldiers under him. Thus, Jesus could heal the servant with just a word without a personal visit. Jesus commends this Roman centurion, saying, "Truly, I tell you, I have not found anyone in Israel with such great faith." Acts chapter 10 records God's choice of Cornelius, a Roman centurion at Caesarea, to be the first Gentile convert to Christianity. An angel appeared to Cornelius saying, "Your prayers and gifts to the poor have come up as a memorial offering before God." Cornelius obeyed the instructions to send to Joppa for the apostle Peter, who came to Cornelius' household and declared the life, the death, and the resurrection of the Lord Jesus. The Holy Spirit came upon Cornelius and his household as they heard the message, and after Peter saw what happened, he ordered that they be baptized with water in the name of Jesus. So we see that the professions of arms are not an impediment to salvation. Like all men, soldiers and police are called to trust and surrender to Jesus Christ. They are called to repent of the same kinds of sins common to man: idolatry, immorality, greed, dishonesty, and so on. But like most people, they are free in Christ to remain in the profession they were in when they were called. Personally, I am thankful for honest and hard-working soldiers and police. I recognize them as being agents of God's wrath to bring consequence to the wrongdoer in accordance with Romans 13. Those who do wrong in the course of their duties need to repent, and they should be brought to justice. But the view of left-wing radicals that these professions are inherently evil, that's wrong. That's a skewed view. That's unjustified. Scripture says, "He who does what is right is righteous. He who does what is sinful is of the devil." These words apply to every person. soldiers and police need to heed the exhortations of John the Baptist to be honest in their work. But since Scripture tells us that God hates differing weights and measures, we would be wrong to hold soldiers and police to a different moral standard than we hold other men and women in faith. A common tactic of the devil is to get us so worked up about the purported sins of others that we forget about our own sins. This is why Jesus told us to get the log out of our own eye before we concern ourselves with the speck in our brother's eye. So what about you? Do you accuse people falsely? Do you say, without any hard evidence, that your neighbor is guilty of some sin? Are you content with your pay? Scripture says, godliness with contentment is great gain. Or do you covet the possessions or the profession of those who appear to have more than you? Are you devising or supporting schemes so you can have more while those of whom you are jealous have less? Let us strive to live at peace with all men. We need to focus our efforts on repentance on our own selves. Sure, we can ask for justice in cases where specific individuals have done wrong, but we err in assuming without evidence that entire professions are guilty based on the sins of a few. God loves police. Jesus loves soldiers.
When I stand in glory, I will see His face, and there I'll serve my King forever in that holy place. Thank you, oh my Father, for giving us your Son and leaving your